What's going on, YouTube? A lot of people want to see me play something, so I'm going to do a song real quick. But I'm not going to put the title of the song or the artist in the title of my video, because I want people to watch my videos because they want to see me show how to do something and not when they're searching for that particular artist. So I'm going to do, now, mind you, I don't consider myself a bassist, a guitarist, or a drummer, or a singer. I just like to mess around with this stuff, and it's a lot of fun, and this song is a lot of fun to play, and it is Killing in the Name of, by Rage Against the Machine. So, let me turn the lights off.
Mm-hmm. God, I'm a cursing.
So that was me playing playing that. So I had a little bit of reverb, a little bit of delay, and basically, and the reason why I'm doing this now is I want to show you how I have it set up in a live environment. This is going straight through the bass amp here, and the amp has a direct out, which is going to channel 4 on the mixer. And that's good because, like I said in previous videos, or you'll see on other tutorial videos, the less microphones you have on a stage, the better it's going to sound. So miking a guitar cabinet is great because you want to have the sound of the guitar through an amp. So you want to mic that. You want to try to capture that sound of a guitar coming through a guitar amp. But with a bass amp, it's not really necessary, and it actually sounds a lot better. I'm going direct out. So you can have, if you're the bassist, you can go have all your effects coming through, and you're going to use your amp as your monitor. This is only for you to hear yourself. It's not for the audience to hear. This is for you to hear. Let the sound guy take that sound and amplify it to your audience. So I also have that going through my lexicon, which I've done on different videos with my voice. If you've seen any of the videos I did with Louie, went through the same lexicon. So just a little bit of delay, a little bit of reverb, and that's only for the front of house audience to hear. The bassist that would be on stage would just hear just a regular, let me just turn this off completely. Now that's only coming through the amp, so there's no effects at all. Because that's all I would need to hear. I mean, if I want to hear some effects to myself, I guess I could. But most bass players aren't going to want to do it. Unless it's like something, like really crazy and they just need to hear it for inspiration or to, I don't know, for whatever reason. But that's it so far. I'm going to show you using the SM57, we're going to mic the guitar amp down here. Maybe I'll play a little bit. I don't think so, but because that's not what my videos are about. It's not me performing. I want to just show you how to hook up stuff. And then I will show you the AKG Perception 170 condenser mic. And we're going to use it on the acoustic there. All right. So see you later.